Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we are going to study the indoor propagation model. We have seen two basic outdoor propagation models. Similarly, indoor propagation models are very important to understand the path loss because of the internal structures of the building. So with the arrival of the personal communication systems, there has been a great deal of interest in understanding the indoor propagation models. So indoor propagation model is nothing but the propagation model within a very smaller distance range. If you remember when we saw outdoor propagation model, the distance was in the range of kilometers, whereas here the distance will now be in the range of meters. So the indoor radio channel differs from the outdoor channel model in certain ways. The very first one is that the distance covered is very much smaller. So the transmitter receiver distance over here is very less. Second, the variability of the environment is very much greater than that of the outdoor propagation models. Since here we have buildings, rooms, partitions, there is a lot of variability that the signal observes rather than in the outdoor propagation model where there is nearly free space, also the variability is very less. Second, the variability in the indoor propagation model is very much higher as compared to the outdoor propagation model. If we consider the outdoor propagation model where there is a free space of communication, or in other hand we can say there is less variability. Whereas if we consider buildings in which we have floors, rooms and partitions, windows, there is a lot of variability that the signal has to face. Next, we come on to the partition losses on the same floor. So there are various models been defined which gives us the different types of path losses. The partition loss on the same floor is due to multiple reasons as discussed. Since we have rooms, windows, ledges, so on, there is partition loss or loss occurring because of that. Buildings have a wide variety of partitions and obstacles which form the internal and the external structure of the building. So losses can occur due to these obstacles. So houses basically have wooden frames partition in which they are filled with plasters, or we have walls that are made up of plasters. Also, there are various materials being used within the floors like concrete and so on. So these also form a part of the loss of the signal. Office building, on the other hand, have open spaces or free spaces. Here the offices are constructed using movable partitions. This is done in order that the reconfiguration of the offices is possible. So for example, if I want to create a cabin or if I want to remove a cabin, it becomes much easier if we have movable partitions. Also between the floors, we have reinforced metal concrete floors that have been used. So partitions that are part of the building are called as a hard partitions. We are not able to move that partitions. Whereas those partitions which are not rising up to the ceiling or are movable are called as soft partitions. So using the soft partitions, we are easily able to reconfigure the space. In the next figure, we can see that there is a database being provided of different materials that are being used that give the different attenuation factor. If you see here, the very first one, that is the all metals, give a loss of 26 dB for frequency that is in the range of 815 MHz. Similarly, we have various metals or materials which give different losses at different frequency. If we see another example, there is a concrete block wall which gives the frequency in the range of 1300 megahertz. The attenuation is 13 dB. So for 1300 megahertz, 13 dB of attenuation is observed using this type of the material. Similarly, various databases are provided for different materials at different frequencies with the attenuation factor. This is nothing but the loss that is calculated in dB. Next, we move on to the partition losses between the floors. The losses between the floors of the building are determined by the external parameters. The losses between the floors of the building are identified by external dimensions as well as the materials that have been used in the building. Also, it depends on the type of the floors that are being created and the external surroundings. In this table, we can see there are three types of buildings. There are three buildings basically, which are named as Walnut Creek, SF Packville, San Ramon. So these are three buildings. All the three buildings are having different numbers of floors. As we can see, the first building, it has got two floors. The next building has got five floors. And the last building has got three floors. For all the floors, we have the value of FAF, which is called as floor attenuation factor at a certain frequency. Also, the value of sigma in dB is shown over here. And finally, we have the number of locations at which the measurement was done. So we have two such tables over here, which gives us the range in the frequency of 915 megahertz and 1900 megahertz. So as we can see here, the attenuation factor or the floor attenuation factor is increasing as the number of floors are increasing. For the first example, we can see it is 33.6 for first floor. For the second floor, it comes out to 44 dB. Similarly, in the next example where we have five floors, we can see the attenuation factor is constantly increasing up to 27.1 dB. Next, we have the log distance path loss model, which is given as, so the indoor path loss model has been shown by many researchers that obey the distance power law. So the log distance path loss model is given by the equation PL in dB is equal to PL of D0 plus 10N log of D by D0 plus X sigma, where N is a path loss exponent, which indicates the rate at which the signal is getting attenuated. D0 is a close in reference distance at which the measurement has been done. D is nothing but the transmitter receiver separation distance. X sigma is the zero mean Gaussian distributed random variable with standard deviation sigma. So we can again see a table over here which gives us the different values of the buildings with respect to the frequency and the path loss exponent N along with the standard deviation sigma. So for example, if we consider the grocery stores at frequency of 914 megahertz, the path loss exponent is 1.8 and the sigma is 5.2, or the standard deviation is 5.2. Next is the attenuation factor model. This model basically provides us with the flexibility to reduce the standard deviation between the measured and the predicted quantity. That was, it reduces from 13 dB that was a predicted to the measured, that is 4 dB. So this is the difference that we are covering when we are using log distance path loss model. So once we are measuring using the attenuation factor model, the path loss comes down to very less value. The attenuation factor model is given by the equation PL of D in dB is equal to PL of D0 in dB plus 10N SF log of D by D0 plus FAF in dB plus summation PAF in dB, where FAF is nothing but the floor attenuation factor, whereas PAF is nothing but the partition attenuation factor. N of SF represents the exponent value for the same floor measurement. So FAF value can be replaced by an exponent factor which considers multiple floors. So here we can see the equation that is modified, that is we are removing now the FAF and we are adding a component which is already taking care of multiple floor component. So the path loss over here becomes PL of D, that is at distance D in dB, is equal to PL of D0 in dB plus 10 N of MF log of D upon D0 plus summation PAF in dB. Your NMF denotes the exponent value for multiple floors. So this is how the path loss has been calculated in indoor propagation models. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to eKida and subscribe to eKida.